Yeah, right. It's Friday then, it's Saturday, Sunday, Hey, what up? It's D. Doing this video just to give a review on the Tusk EMEX T35 rear tire. I have a 110-9019 on my Husky FC350. And this is how I remove them on a drum and stuff. Just over the years, I've done a lot of tires. So we're getting into this one. This is a Dunlop MX33 I'm replacing with this Tusk tire. And it came off, it went on the same as a Dunlop would. It's like the same kind of a compound as far as the rubber. It's really like elasticity to it, I guess. I don't know if that's the right word. But anyway, I'm just winging this. I chose to go with this tire because a Dunlop MX33 was not available when I was ordering a tire and I needed one due to COVID. But so this tire cost me $56 delivered to my door. And that's from RMATVMC. Love that place. I order a bunch of stuff from them just because of the shipping so fast. If you haven't checked them out, you won't be disappointed. But anyway, I was doing this and all the times I've done it, I scratched my rim. I was pretty upset about that. Even with these new tire irons I have, like right now, it just slipped and the DID rim scratches easy. But anyway, yeah, so for $56, I figured I'd give it a shot. In comparison to the MX33, it's what it should be. It's a soft intermediate tire. I've got like 5 hours on it now. The knobs are very similar. The outside edge knobs are a little bit thicker, like it's like millimeters difference in like the square cubes. They're a little bit bigger than what's on the MX33, so I would assume there's less going around than an MX33. It's probably like shy like two knobs, let's say. It's like that small of a difference. But anyway, like you can see how soft they are. I can squeeze the knobs. This is definitely an awesome like intermediate soft tire, and I'm a soft tire kind of a person. But yeah, and I mounted it up. It looks great. The rubber compound looks awesome, feels awesome. I'm excited to try it out. Can't wait to get on the track. So I rode it on three different tracks. Today was a real like loamy, like muddy track that had a lot of traction in it. So of course it was gonna work well there. It's brand new. The thing was pulling wheelies out of corners like nothing. But I wanted to see if it would chunk and how it would handle, you know, like square edge chop and stuff like that. See if I would get anything, any feedback, if it's a real stiff tire on the casing or not. Anyway, so I went, this was at MX23 I was at in Massachusetts, and the track, it performed awesome here. Then I've went to a couple other tracks, one Jolly Roger MX or NHMX up in New Hampshire. That one is more like hard pack with like square edge, like high speed accelerating bumps and stuff, and it performed awesome there. And then this past weekend I went to Wareham MX in Massachusetts, which is a sand track. So I've tested pretty much all the soils with it, and I am stoked. I'm buying the tire again if I have to, but after 5 hours on it, it doesn't even look like it's been touched. So as you can see on this track, plenty of traction, not a problem here. A lot of ruts. It had a lot of sidewall bite, so it wouldn't slide out. Actually, my front tire, my MX33, was sliding out more than my Tusk on the back. So it was kind of cool because I'm like offset with tire brands. But yeah, like going in the ruts and this kind of like real loamy, grippy soil with like wood chips and stuff in it. It worked awesome. Ton of positive traction. I didn't have a problem with it. Like landings felt great. It didn't feel stiff. I'm running 12 PSI in this tire. I usually run 12 and a half. I figured I'd try 12, give it a little softer. feel and bite better on the flat turns. But anyway, yeah, I just wanted to say real quick, the track, the tire is awesome. I wouldn't hesitate. I tried. I will buy one again. I definitely would try it. Check them out. I bought it at RMATBMC, $56 to my door. All right, guys. You can continue to watch a little of the moto if you'd like. Please like and subscribe. But I'll catch you later. Thanks.